from FiberFlux. Welcome back to another weekly update and a very happy June to all of you as well. In case you're joining us for the first time, the weekly updates are where I share everything going on in the FiberFlux world, whether it is a sneak peek or a work in progress or maybe some new yarn or things like that. The first thing I wanted to talk about with you today is, in case you missed it last week also, this banner behind me, I will share the links for both the granny triangles and this square as well. The other thing I did that was fun and exciting was I went to the yarn store, and last week I shared the colors of scrubby cotton with all of you, these sort of pink and tan shades. Well, I went and bought some more. I needed some more colors for the project that I'm working on that I'll share with you later this week. So this is Jade. This one is called Caribbean. This one is Lemony and Lavender. And then this one is called Cotton. So I have a lot of colors. I'm going to try and pick all these up at once. I have a lot of colors, and there's going to be a couple of patterns with these coming soon. The comments that you left last week, I asked you to choose spa or kitchen, and a lot of you said spa and a lot of you said kitchen, so I'm going to do both. So stay tuned for those. And I also wanted to mention, as far as the comments go, the first weekly update that I had last week, the comments that you all left behind were so positive and so kind. So I just want to thank you all for all of the wonderful things that you said. The next thing that I want to talk about in this week's update is knitting. So a lot of you have asked me for knitting patterns, or you're just learning how to knit. So I want to start doing more knitting tutorials as well. Now, FiberFlux is primarily a crochet website. We do lots and lots of crochet on FiberFlux, either together in a crochet along, or I share patterns. However, so many of you have been asking me for knitting projects. So I'm gonna start providing more knitting tutorials. Basic stitches, some knitting for beginners, some easy projects. I happen to have something on the needles here that I'll be sharing soon. This is with Red Heart Gleam, and there'll be a Yarn 101 for this as well. The one I happen to have here is a pretty charcoal with some kind of gold thread going through that. But this is a work in progress on the needles, and it'll be a free knitting pattern coming soon. Another thing that I got in the mail this week is the new Yarn Crush box. So look for the unboxing of this later on this week. And as you can see, it comes in this really pretty purple wrapper. It's like a present that comes in the mail. So I will be unboxing this later in the week. So stay tuned for that as well. So I mentioned just a moment ago how I got some new colors of the Red Heart Scrubby Cotton. And while I was there getting these colors, I also found these cute little scissors. These are actually embroidery scissors, but I love having little scissors on hand in my tote bag for just trimming small little yarn ends. But these are striped and they look so summery. So I definitely had to share those with all of you. And I also found this super cute robot patch. So I'm not really sure what to do with him yet, but I just thought it was really cute. So robot patch and these little scissors. And these were, I think, like $2.99. So they were very affordable and very cute for summer. Another thing I want to share, in my last weekly update, I shared my project with the Red Heart Ombre yarn. I'm still working on it and it's coming along very nicely. I love how the colors are playing out. So this is coming very, very soon. I only have a few more inches to go. So that will be coming up as well. In all of my videos, I like to also share a pattern that's maybe been around for a while, but something I think is really perfect for the season that we're in. So this week's pattern is this. This is the Lake House Wrap. And I shared this a few months ago. This is with the Red Heart Soft Essentials yarn. And I use this really pretty soft teal and this light heather gray color and a navy. So this is just some chunky lace, very simple stitches. I'll put the link down below for this. But this is perfect for those rainy, cooler days in spring and maybe in the summer when buildings and rooms are very heavily air conditioned. It's really nice to have a couple of wraps like this on hand to have just to kind of throw around your shoulders. And then when you go out into the warm air outside, you know, you can just kind of tuck it away. So it's really nice to have a couple of these pieces for the season. The last thing I wanted to share with you is something I've actually had for a while, and let me go ahead and grab that because I was cleaning out my crafty space the other day and I came across this. I got it in the mail and I carefully looked at it because it is a little bit fragile, wrapped it up and put it away and forgot all about it. So the thing that I wanted to share is, now this was a while ago, my channel, the FiberFlux YouTube channel, hit 100,000 subscribers. Now we're in the 180s now, but I wanted to share this with you because without the subscribers, all of you, I would never have received this award. So YouTube, when you hit 100,000 subscribers on your channel, they send you this really fantastic plaque. It's a silver play button and it says, "Congratulations for surpassing 100,000 subscribers," and on it is FiberFlux. And so this is really special. So I just wanted to thank all of you for making this possible and for making the FiberFlux YouTube channel so wonderful, and the community is so wonderful, and there's a lot of positivity. So this is all about you guys, and I just wanted to thank you for this lovely award from YouTube, and also thanks to YouTube as well. They also send a little letter, you know, just congratulating you, but it's from YouTube, so that's pretty neat. So I'm going to be, I really should hang this up. It's been in a box for a while, and I really should display it. It is really nice, and it's framed and in glass and everything. So special thanks to all of you as well for making that happen. So those are my weekly updates for this week. I will be getting the knit crate in soon as well. So in the next weekly update, I'll be sharing that also. One last thing I wanted to mention is some of you have asked me about questions. So I'm going to start doing a monthly Q&A. So look for that coming in the next couple days or in the next week or so. And so I'll be grabbing a handful of questions and sharing them with all of you as well. Because I feel like if one person has a question, perhaps many of you are wondering the same thing as well. So that is the weekly update. Thank you so much for watching and for hanging in there and for all of your kind comments. And be sure and click that subscribe button below so you can get all the weekly updates. So we have weekly updates, tutorials, crochet alongs where we all crochet together. So stay tuned for the next weekly update and I'll see you next week. Bye everyone.